was a very good indicator of this group of kids that have played together for a very long time. Just get by with a little help from my friends. These kids are more than friends. They're brothers. And with that, let's get this recognition program going. Coach Minto has given me some nice words to say. So we will start out right now. Number three, Ethan Santos. Ethan is escorted by his mother and father, Tammy and Matthew Santos. He has played infield, outfield, and pitched over his three-year varsity career. Earlier this year, Ethan received the WNSP Athlete of the Week Award. Within his 4 years in the Baker baseball program, Santos' most memorable moment was the walk-off win against Bayside and Coach Frosty taking us to Buffalo Wild Wings. The attitude and work ethic are not only on display on the diamond, but also in the classroom and events on campus. Ethan is a consistent member of the AB Honor Roll and has a 3.5 GPA, as well as leading those Hornet hooligans. Ethan will be attending Bishop State on a baseball scholarship while focusing on a degree in mechanical engineering. He would like to thank God, his family, his coaches, and his friends. Ethan Santos. All right. Now, number 14, Damon Fountain. Damon is being escorted by his father, Damien, and his mother, Holly Fountain. When given the choice, Damon usually wears number 12 on his jersey. This year, he was awarded with the number 14 as a commemoration to Carson Cazaraz. This number is selected by the coaches for a player who gives everything 100% and does it with a smile on their face as Carson would. Damon has served as a second baseman and shortstop during his tenure here. Damon will attend Bishop State in the fall as part of the FAME Apprentice Program. His well-roundedness is shown in several aspects of Damon's life. In the classroom, Damon boasts an impressive 3.7 GPA and is a member of the National Technical Honor Society. Damon has been a member of the Baker Baseball Program for 4 years, with this serving as a second year on varsity. During those years, his favorite moment was beating Bayside and Coach Frosty buying us 200 wings to eat. Damon would like to thank his family for all the support and sacrifices they have made throughout his baseball career. He would also like to thank the coaches for all the time and effort they have dedicated throughout this baseball program and his many lessons in life he has learned and will use to make him a successful man as he gets older. Ladies and gentlemen, Damon Fountain. All right, now number 18, Camden Payne. Camden is escorted by his mother and father, Summer and Buck Payne, and his sister, Elise Payne. Camden has been a member of the Baker baseball program for 4 years and a member of the varsity for two. During that time, Cam has played both corners of the infield as well as pitched for the Hornets. His success on the diamond has earned him a Midtown Optimist Club Player of the Week award this season. In the classroom, Cam also continues to display his hard work and determination with a 3.5 GPA. Next year, Cam has signed a baseball scholarship to play for Bishop State, where he will pursue a degree in business. During Camden's time in the program, his favorite memory was staying after practice and hitting with Coach Lloyd Frost. Cam would like to thank all of his coaches, his family, and his dad. Camden Payne, ladies and gentlemen. All right, next up, number 19, Bryson B-Sud Suddeth. Bryson is escorted by Jennifer Suddeth and Tanya Smith, as well as his sister, Addison Suddeth. Bryson has been a member of the Baker baseball program for 4 years and a member of the varsity program for three. During his time in the program, Bryson has thrown big innings for the Hornets and has played the outfield as well. Bryson has committed to play for the Central Alabama Community College and Coach Thomas next season, where he plans to major in business. We are proud of Bryson and the hard work that he has put in, not only on the baseball field, but also in the classroom, and boasts a 3.0 GPA. During his time in the Baker baseball program, Bryson's favorite memory was the bus ride home after the Prattville Series victory in the first round of the playoffs last year. Bryson would like to take a moment to thank his parents and coaches for getting him to where he is today. Ladies and gentlemen, Bryson Suddeth. All right. Next up on the list, number 22, Connor Gatwood. Connor is escorted by his dad, Dwayne Gatwood, grandmother Judy Sand, and grandfather Pete Sand, and aunt Tina Seals. Connor has been a three-year member of varsity and a four-year member of the Baker program as a pitcher, an outfielder, and an infielder. Next year, pending the MLB draft, Connor will suit up for the Auburn Tigers while pursuing a degree in business. As well as earning a 3.4 GPA, Connor has compiled quite the list of accomplishments under such as the Under Armour All-American Team selection, the MLB High School All-American selection, Midtown Optimist Player of the Week awards, Midtown Optimist Terrific 12. During his 4 years, Gat's favorite memory was when Connor Fadala hit the walk-off home run last year to save his 15-strikeout no-hitter in the first round of the playoffs. Connor would like to thank his family, friends, and coaches. Ladies and gentlemen, Connor Gatwood. All right, coming up next, number 24, Brian Durbin. Brian is escorted by his mother, Keisha Holler, stepfather, Shane Holler, and his sisters, Anna and Brindley, and brother, Kale. Bryant has been a member of the Baker baseball program for 4 years and a member of the varsity program for three. During his time in the program, Durbin has been a mainstay for the Hornets in the outfield while throwing some big-time innings on the mound. While Bryant received an academic scholarship to the University of South Alabama, he has committed to play for Bishop State and Coach Hadestein next season, where he plans to major in engineering. With an impressive 3.7 GPA, Bryant's work is shown through his commitment to education. During his time in the Baker baseball program, Durbin's favorite memory was homering in his first ever varsity at bat and laying down the best bunt of his career in his second at bat. Bryant would like to thank God, his family, the coaching staff throughout the last 4 years, and last but not least, his teammates. Ladies and gentlemen, Bryant Durbin. All right, next, coming down the first baseline, number 25, Peyton Buck. Peyton is escorted by his mom, Michelle Buck, his dad, Eddie Buck, his sisters, Aubrey Garris and Kendall Buck. Peyton has played a consistent role behind the plate over his four-year baseball career at Baker. Earlier this week, Peyton was awarded the Midtown Optimist Club's Player of the Week. Within his 4 years of the Baker baseball program, Buck's most memorable moment was the night at the hotel after we swept Prattville in the first round of the playoffs. The attitude and work ethic are not only on display on the diamond, but also in the organizations and events on campus. Buck is a consistent member of the honor roll and has a remarkable 4.5 GPA while being a member of the National Honor Society, the Hornet Hooligans, and the FCA. Although Peyton will have several options, he is undecided on his college where he will focus in a degree in nursing. Peyton would like to thank all of his coaches while growing up and here at Baker. Ladies and gentlemen, Peyton Buck. All right, next up, number 26, Micah Cornelius. Micah is escorted by his parents, Scott and Sally Cornelius, and his brother, Brayton, also a previous member of Baker High School Baseball. Micah has been a member of the Baker baseball program for the last four seasons while playing a crucial role in several positions. Micah has served time on the mound, in the infield, and in the outfield for the Hornets. In the classroom, Micah has shown success with a 3.82 GPA with memberships to the National Technical Honor Society as well as the National Honor Society. Micah will graduate with an honors diploma. Next year, Micah will attend Bishop State to focus on a degree in industrial maintenance with instrumentation. As a member of the Hornets, Micah's favorite moment was eating Buffalo Wild Wings with Coach Frosty after the walk-off victory versus Bayside. Micah would like to thank his coaches throughout his high school career, Coach Frosty, Coach Minto, and Coach Larry, Coach Boatman, and Coach Williams. Ladies and gentlemen, Micah Cornelius. All right, next up, number 13, Colin Wilson. Colin is escorted by his mother, Lorna Wilson, and his father, Travis Wilson, Sr., and his brother, Travis Wilson, Jr. Colin has and will continue to be a cherished entity of the Baker baseball program. Not many people have ever gone from asking to be a manager on the team to getting hits for a ranked varsity program. The hard work Colin puts in will translate into his next venture as he plans to attend trade school after graduating from Baker High School. Colin has been a member of the Baker baseball program for the last 4 years. Within those 4 years, Colin's favorite memory is when he left Frosty's clipboard outside in the rain. Whoops! Colin would like to thank his family and his coaches. Ladies and gentlemen, Colin Wilson. All right, lastly, another message from Coach Minto. Coach Minto would like to thank Jen, our trainer, for all her efforts in keeping these young men treated and healthy. The Booster Club for all their efforts in making this program what it is today. Their time, efforts, and commitment is greatly appreciated. He'd like to thank his wife, Claire, for her countless efforts in all aspects of this program. To the parents of the baseball program, we are grateful for your belief in us as coaches and to help guide these young men into adulthood. Your continuous support and efforts have made this year a pleasure as well as set an example for years to come. This has been a special group of young men, and as we tell our players, the path is not about starting or the finish line, but the process in between. The journey between those lines is where we learn the valuable lessons within life itself. The trials and adversity, how to handle success and how to handle failure, is what makes the finish line obtainable. Through faith and perseverance, we are able to find our way. Tough times never last, but tough people do. Thank you all. Ladies and gentlemen, the 2024 seniors from the Baker Hornet baseball team.
If I have